You said that the first time he was inside the holy grave and saw the immediate light up of the candle, but the second one he was less faithful and didn't saw the holy light. So the first time he went inside, he had in mind the charges of Latins, that someone has a lighter with him and lights up the candles. If this had happened, the holy grave would no longer belong to Greek Orthodox. He saw ancient Greek capital letters at a point not visible near the chamber of the grave. He went inside from the point he found, but he had to find a way to get out then, because it was high enough as 4 meters. He couldn't just jump down and go. He had to use stairs or something. But fortunately, from his happiness, he saw the holy light, hung down and jumped. So the first time he saw the holy light, touched it, but not burned. These are the unexplainable, but for those who have faith, nothing is unexplainable. When he touched the holy light, he put his hand upon his face, and from then and now on, he has a shining on his face. He was 93 years old. Father Mitrofanis, we would like you to tell us when you were born.
In 1900.
Where?
East of Kerasunda, in a Komopolis named Latzaki.
Are you from Pontos?
Yes, I am from Pontos, Kerasunda.
Tell us how you left your homeland.
In 1921, Turkish terrorists were against us, and at 4th of June, day of Friday, the celebration of Saint Mitrofanis, we were forced to leave our place, and after a difficult journey, we arrived at Nicopolis of Armenia. After 10 days, they left us and managed to go at Diyarbakir in Kurdistan.
The second time, Elder Mitrofanis decided to go again. He admitted after that the biggest sin was not that he was not believing, but the fact he didn't believe what he saw with his own eyes. He climbed at the same spot he was in the previous time, waiting 13 hours, but unfortunately he didn't saw anything. Why Father Mitrofanis decided to leave the Holy Land and go to Thessaloniki? He was 81 years old, so he couldn't say psalms anymore, but according to him, the prayer was coming directly from his soul. He asked the patriarch to go somewhere to live in a peace from now on. He couldn't be a holy grave guard anymore. For Father Mitrofanis, the experience of holy light was the most remarkable of his life. Yes, he remembered that was a narrow like a white smoke, which glowed everything at the chamber of the grave. That happened in 1923. Everything was shining like there were 1,000 bulbs, but this time there was no electricity in the grave. How much time after the interview you took from him he died?
2 years after he died.